Hello, everyone, and welcome to the March 2025 Sky Report. My name is Vanessa, and I'm joined today by Patrick.
Hi, everyone.
Let's see what's happening in the skies this month. On March 6th, the moon will pass in front of the bright star Elnath in the constellation of Taurus in an event called a grazing occultation. Here, zoomed in, you can see that the very edge of the moon will come in contact with Elnath at 8:49 p.m. for us in Los Angeles, according to the International Occultation Timing Association. It will reappear at around 8:57 p.m. These times are very dependent on your location on the Earth, so being even just one city over can make a difference. So if you'd like to see this in Southern California, start looking with binoculars at around 8:40 p.m. so that you don't miss it. On March 7th, Mercury reaches its greatest elongation, which means it is as far away from the Sun as it can be in our sky. This is at 6:20 p.m., and Mercury will be about 12 degrees above the horizon still. This is one of very few decent opportunities to look at Mercury with a telescope, so try and find it. Be sure that the Sun has completely set before trying to find the planet with a telescope or binoculars. Always use proper safety precautions, and if you are unsure, ask an experienced observer.
Daylight saving time starts on March 9th. Be sure to set your clocks forward by 1 hour in California. This change brings an extra hour of daylight in the evening, with the sun setting an hour later than the day before. A total lunar eclipse will take place late on the night of March 13th. The lunar eclipse will be visible from the Americas, Western Europe, and Western Africa. A total lunar eclipse happens when the moon moves into the Earth's deepest shadow, the umbra, causing it to darken for a little over an hour. In Los Angeles, the moon will enter the Earth's lighter shadow, the penumbra, at 8:57 p.m. PDT. During this phase, the moon will gradually fade, with its western side becoming slightly darker as it moves closer to the umbra. At 10:09 p.m. PDT, the moon's west side enters the umbra, causing it to become noticeably darker. This marks the beginning of the partial phase of the lunar eclipse. At 11:26 p.m. PDT, totality begins as the moon becomes fully immersed in the umbra. At 11:59 p.m. PDT, the greatest eclipse occurs and the moon takes on a reddish hue from the sunlight refracted through the Earth's atmosphere, reflecting the light of all the world's sunrises and sunsets. From the moon's perspective, the Earth has fully eclipsed the sun. The Earth is encircled by a bright reddish ring of refracted sunlight filtering through its atmosphere. Totality ends at 12:31 a.m. PDT as the moon moves out of the umbra. At 1:48 a.m. PDT, the moon fully exits the umbra. The eclipse is over at 3 a.m. PDT. The umbral eclipse lasts for 3 hours and 39 minutes, with the moon fully eclipsed for 1 hour and 5 minutes. The next total eclipse visible from Los Angeles will be on March 3, 2026. Weather permitting, Griffith Observatory will broadcast the total lunar eclipse live. You can watch the broadcast through a link to our YouTube channel at griffithobservatory.org under upcoming events. Spring arrives when the vernal equinox occurs at 2:01 a.m. PDT on March 20th. At the time of the equinox, the Sun is located exactly on the intersection of the celestial equator, the Earth's equator projected into the sky, and the zero right ascension line or longitude in the sky. The vernal equinox marks the beginning of spring in the northern hemisphere and the start of autumn in the southern hemisphere. Looking east at 10 p.m., the constellation Boötes the Herdsman rises alongside Virgo the Maiden. The brightest star in Boötes is Arcturus, the fourth brightest star in the sky. Not only is it luminous, but it also shines with a distinct orange-red hue. Looking west at 10 p.m., the winter constellations Orion, Taurus, and Canis Major make their final appearances in the night sky. By the end of the month, they will be setting early, lingering close to the horizon. The brilliant planet Jupiter sets just after 1 a.m. By the end of the month, it sets just before 11:30 p.m.
Looking to the north, the constellation of Ursa Major, which contains the asterism the Big Dipper, appears upside down this time of year. Most of these constellations, like Cepheus, Draco, and Ursa Minor, are difficult to see in the light-polluted skies of Los Angeles.
Since last August, Venus has shone brilliantly in our evening sky. Watch as it gradually sinks towards the horizon each night. On the 5th, it will be 17 degrees above the western horizon. By the 10th, Venus will have descended to just 10 degrees above the western horizon. By the 15th, Mercury remains visible and is worth spotting with a pair of binoculars. Meanwhile, Venus is just 5 degrees above the western horizon before disappearing from view as it passes between Earth and the Sun, eventually shifting into the morning sky.
And here is your lunar calendar for March. First quarter is on the 6th. Full moon is on the 13th. The last quarter is on the 22nd. And the new moon is on the 29th. That's all we have for this month, but if you want to watch the lunar eclipse, be sure to watch our broadcast on March 13th. Thank you so much for joining us this month, and we'll see you again next month. Bye!
Bye.